Hello everybody, it's Ellie Diecast, and this is going to be a quick customs video. We'll take a look at that Torino and that Combi. I got those finished up. We've got quite a few customs coming along here. Those were the first two that got finished up. In the background there are some of Peter Kong's cars that I restored quickly. I didn't spend a lot of time on them, but got them all cleaned up and in better shape. But first, I did get a question. Let me get a sample. And that was somebody, this was a while back, this was a few months back, but somebody had asked how I made these little paint posts, or the sticks, the posts that I put my customs on. And I did not get to answer it, so I don't remember who asked the question. But it is a question I had when I was starting this whole thing. I really had no idea how to set up my shop so that I could get things painted well. And so I was trying everything from holding the customs of pliers to like sticks with putty on the bottom, all sorts of stuff. And nothing really worked. Everything ended up just, it would fall and clunk around on the ground and scratch the paint up, and it just wasn't consistent enough for my taste. So somebody, not my idea, but online I saw somebody had come up with this very cool idea of taking dowel rods. That is a dowel rod with a electrical connector, a female electrical connector on the top, and then put a screw in it. So here's how you do it. First, you go down to Walmart and go in the craft section, and you get yourself some of these guys, these 3/16 dowel rods. They're round dolls, the dowels. They're where the tongue depressors are, and the puff balls, all the little crafty stuff, ribbon, all that stuff. And they're like 74 cents for 8 of them. They're really cheap. And you can even cut them in half if you want twice as many. Then you need to whittle this down a little bit. So what I do is I just take my X-Acto knife and just whittle it down. You don't have to be exact. Then, I'm going to move this car so I don't clunk against it. Then, you go down to Home Depot or your local hardware store, and you get these little electrical connectors, and I honestly don't remember the name of what they're called, but they're for soldering electrical equipment together. And you can get them in Home Depot. They're in the wiring section, the electrical department. You can get them anywhere, Target, Walmart. And I don't know what size these are. I just know I always get the blue. So I don't know if that's a universal size or if that's what they got, but you want them so they fit on top of your dowel rod. And if you want them to be bigger or smaller, well, you get a bigger or smaller dowel rod and you fit them all up. And you see you got to whittle them down a little bit because they won't fit if you don't. Then you make sure that stick sticks way up in there. I would need to whittle that down a little bit more. And glue it on, and glue it on with some hardy piece of, or hardy type of glue. I use JB Weld for it. That seems to do the trick. Come on. There you go. I use JB Weld for it. And then use your little button screws that you use on the bottom of the cars. And I do not remember the name. Is it the size? Is it 256th? Is that right? I think it's 256th. Just a second. So it's the button screws are the 256th size. I use the 1/8. You could also use the 1/4. I have both, but I find the 1/8 has a little bit better stick to the car. And then you bend this little part right here. You bend that back. And you got to be careful because it'll rip right here. It's kind of supposed to. Bend it back. And then where you drill out the posts on your cars, like right there, then you stick those screws in there, tie them on, or screw them on tight, and then when you paint it, you can get to the car from any angle. You can keep the paint away from your hands. When you stick them down onto a board to store them, if you have half that are tall and half that are short, you can store quite a bit of cars on a board. And all I do is I just use a regular piece of scrap wood, drill some holes big enough to hold the base of the dowel, and stick the dowel down into that hole. And I drill like 20 holes in a board, And that's what I use until it wears out, and I throw it out and make a new one. So, just thought you would want to know that. That has been asked before. Okay, back to the cars. Cars I don't even need to talk about as much. Got this Torino with the blue flames. I think we saw this one in the background in another video. The wheels do move on it. Very happy with this one. Polished the hell out of this thing to get that finished. I probably polished that thing more than any other car I've ever polished. I wanted to see how much of a mirror finish I could get on that thing. I got some fingerprints on it, but other than that, it's pretty slick. Used tampos from Pato's place and a few extras that I had around. The interior is just black with a few highlights in silver. But real happy with that. No surprise it's a Torino. Oh, I should mention, I do have the license plate tampos. It has two openings for license plates, but I misplaced them. So when they turn up, I'll put the license plates on them. I'm not going to trade this one or sell it. That one is for me. This guy, little combi. You've seen this one in the background a few times. I think it was even as a paint test when it first came around, but I first painted this about a year and a half ago now. It was one of the first ones I painted. It's been sitting here in the shop ever since. We have a lot of those around. And it was a dark green with a light green fade. I masked off the flames with the masks that we sell on our site. By the way, I didn't mention the Torino. The masks are also available on the site. This top piece, that comes with this mask set. I used a piece of pinstriping tape to get the stripe, and then I covered the whole thing with a flat black. And this is the first time I've used upholstery spray in the flat black, and I like it a lot better. I got three different brands, and I've been trying them out, and once I figure out which brand I like the best, I'll share it with you. But just get the premium spray paint for flat black. I think it works better. It doesn't have the milky white highlight. It has more of a flat sheen to it. It's also covered in a flat coat, like a flat clear coat. And I use this microflat as my protecting layer. It's not really a clear. It's not made out of the same stuff. You can get this microflat at Micromart. I use it for train building, train sets, quite a bit. Train hobby. And then for the gloss sheen here, this is just Rust-Oleum glaze, clear glaze, and it's got about three coats and then polished down. This one, I don't polish that, or the flat won't look really flat. So, real quickly, we'll take a look. Oh, I should mention, some people they always email me with the paint layers. This one was a dark gray primer with a blue, it wasn't that color blue, it was, oh, I'm sorry, dark gray primer with a gold coat, then the blue, and the gold isn't going to show through here, but it's kind of got a metal flake finish to it, masked off the blue, and then covered it in a gloss black. This one, I think, was a white primer coat, it was a long time ago. The green and light green, it's the same green mixed with a yellow, but that's just a quick fade, and then I masked it off and covered it with the flat black. So this one, doesn't quite shark well. See that dull sheen in the green there? You can get that by mixing aluminum color into your paints. And I use Wicked color, so you'll have to kind of figure out what the equivalent is. But either Wicked aluminum, which works great. It kind of gives it a dull metal sheen to it. I think it's made, again, for the train hobby. I just picked it up here for Hot Wheels. Or you could use a silver, but if you're going to use a silver and you want the dull sheen, don't use a silver with like a metal flake in it. And then you just mix them together and spray it on. All right, let's look at these little quickies. These are just restores, and this is from Peter Kong's collection, which if you saw those video, he had donated these. These are two of his cars. Both of these were pretty well trashed. They were both little super fast cars, so I kept the wheels on them. I repainted the hubs, repainted the inside. There is no color combination like this in real super fast cars of this little, little dump loader, isn't it? What is this guy? He is officially a... tractor shovel. There is no black-red combination, but I wanted to save him. Also, I redid all of the plastic, so all of this has been sanded down and then restored using acrylic. So I just dip it in acrylic and it brings back the sheen a little bit. This one I like. I don't have this one. And so it caught my attention. It has this cool little gizmo here that turns the front wheel. Is this like an asphalt paver or something? It's a... rod roller. Not so sure you're going to be racing in that one, but... And this one is just a simple matter of stripping the paint down and just repainting it. On both of these, a good trick when you're restoring these cars, especially if all you want to do is just restore them and put paint on them so they look good on a shelf. I'm not talking about restoring them to like collector quality standards, but these wheels really won't come off without just destroying them. They're on a very thick axle. It's like a steel axle in there, and it's set into the casting and then capped off with like a rivet head. So you can't really get them out easy. You don't need to. Oh, I'm sorry. These wheels do come out. I meant these wheels here. These wheels here. You can see that capped rivet head. So I can't get that little wheel out to strip the paint out, to strip the paint off. It really doesn't matter. The paint stripper that I use, which is just the Walmart paint stripper brand, it won't hurt the plastic. So you just dip everything in, the wheel will stay fine, and you just leave it in there. And then you use a toothbrush to get your paint off. And then when you repaint it, just cover that wheel with masking tape. Just be real careful. You just wrap masking tape around the outside, pinch around the edges, clean up some little gaps, and then spray it. And then you just take the paint off, and you never took the wheel off the car. A lot of these old super fast cars are like that. They're built like tanks, so sometimes those axles really won't come out easily. You don't really have to take them out, especially if all you're trying to do is paint it a different color. It's just a good trick for beginners. So that's going to do it for this one. Peter, if you like either of these, if once you get around to watching these, if you like either of those, tell me and I'll send them back to you along with the customs we're working on. So more customs to come, everybody, and I will see you all later. Bye bye.